Hey guys, Jatin here, and today we are going to complete our paddleboard. In the last video, we made the hull of the paddleboard, which is right here, and the pins. Today we are going to make the paddle, the part which pushes the boat inside the water. The paddle is going to be placed inside this hole in the paddleboard. Now, before making the paddleboard, we need to monitor the size of the hole inside the paddleboard. Why? Because the paddle will sit inside this hole and it has to be smaller than the hole, otherwise it will clash with the part of the side of the paddleboard. So now we will use the tape measure tool and monitor the size. The length of the hole is right now 55 mm and the width is 45 mm. So now we have to make sure that the paddle is smaller in length than 55 mm and smaller in width than 45 mm, right? So this is the part which involves some designing, and that's what I've done. I've used a paper and a pencil and drew the paddle board, drew the design of the paddle on the paper, and that's how I can give a rough dimension and a brief small structure to the paddle so that when I'm designing, my paddle comes just right. So let's skip to the design phase. Okay, so this is what I have designed for the paddle inside the paddle board. Now, if I remember correctly, the length of the hole inside the paddle board is 55 mm in length, so I've kept the paddle size as 45 mm. I've kept the fin size as 20 mm as the fins go round the axle and the length is represented two times in the length of the whole paddle. So the length of the fins is kept as 20 mm and the axle in the middle, the diameter of the axle is kept as 5 mm. So this gives us a total length of 20 plus 20, 40 plus 5 mm, a total length of 45 mm for the paddleboard. So after our design phase, we now know that the middle axle of the paddle needs to be 5 mm in diameter and size of one fin would be 20 mm in diameter. So now we can start designing the paddle. Alright, so let's designate a space for the paddle where we'll start designing. I'm using this space right here, and then I'll use the circle tool to start making the axle of the paddle. Now my axle is 5 mm in diameter. The dimension in SketchUp for the circle is radius. So the radius obviously will be 2.5 mm. So I'll write 2.5 and press enter. Now my circle is 2.5 mm in radius or 5 mm in diameter. Now the size of one fin would be 20 mm. So I'll now draw a rectangular fin of length 20 mm. I'll just pick one end of the circle and draw a line perpendicular to it of length 20 mm. So I'll write 20 and enter. Again, I'll just adjacent to that line, I'll choose another endpoint and draw a line perpendicular of length 20 mm and connect it on the top. And now we have one fin of a paddle ready. Now my paddle is going to have six fins, right? Now I want all the fins to be equidistant to the fin adjacent to one another, right? So six fins means a angle of 60 degree between two adjacent fins, right? And how am I going to accomplish that? I'm going to use the rotate tool. Actually, we are going to focus on one very, very important concept right now, which is called the copy and rotate, in which we are going to copy this fin and place it exactly at a specific angle to the start point. All right. So now how do we start this? We are first going to start by selecting what we want to copy. The fin here is the portion that we want to copy right now, so we will select the fin. you can see that the dotted appearance on the fin is signifying that the fin has now been selected. The circle is not selected, the fin is selected. Now, we go to the rotate option. We click. The rotate option needs two clicks to work. One at the center point and the other at the axis along which you want it to rotate. So, the first click will be in the center, the second click will be anywhere on the object that you want to rotate. So we click anywhere on the fin and we see that when we rotate, the fin is rotating. But we want a copy of this fin, right? So to get a copy, we are just going to briefly press Control. That's it. We'll just press Control on the keyboard and you will see that a copy will appear. I press Control and see, a copy has just now appeared of the fin that we were trying to copy. Now, we want to place this fin at an angle of 60 degrees from the original fin. So how am I going to do that? You can see in the bottom right corner that an angle measurement is appearing. So just like we give length for a line, we can give angle here. So we can type 60 and press enter. And you will see that the fin pops up at an angle of exactly 60 degrees from the original fin. Now, we have just done an operation of copy and rotate on the SketchUp environment. So now this SketchUp knows this operation. Can we copy this operation and tell SketchUp to do it automatically 6 times more? Yes, we can. How? You just type X and 6. Don't click or do any unselecting operation. Just type X6 and press enter. And you'll see that SketchUp will automatically copy the whatever operation you did 6 times more, and you will get the paddle with 6 fins displaced exactly 60 degrees from one another. I'll do this again. I'll Control Z so that we have the original fin again. Now, again, copying is very, very important, in that you first have to select what you want to copy. So I'll first select the fin. I'll click on rotate. I'll click on the center of the circle. Then I'll click on any part of the fin. Now you see that I am moving the fin, I'm not copying the fin. That's because I haven't pressed Control. So I'll press Control and a copy of the fin automatically pops up, which I can place 60 degrees by typing 60 on my keyboard, and you can see that the angle has appeared in the bottom right corner. So now I press enter and the fin has been placed 60 degrees displaced from the original fin. Now I want to repeat this operation 6 times. What I'll do is I'll leave the mouse, I don't need to touch the mouse anymore. I'll just type X6, which tells SketchUp to multiply this operation 6 times, and press enter. And you see that my fin has been copied 6 times, displaced exactly 60 degrees from the original fin. And that's it. The paddle is almost done. We just need to push pull it. Now, the width of the hole in the paddle boat is 45 mm. So obviously we need to keep the width of the paddle lesser than 45 mm. So we'll keep it around 35 mm. We'll delete these lines because they are separating equivalent surfaces from one another. So now that our surface is being identified as one, we can just push pull this up and type 35 and press enter. And there you go, our paddle for the paddle boat is now ready. And this completes our paddle boat project. You can see that the paddle boat is now complete and it's ready to print. You just need to download it or export it as a DAE model in SketchUp, import it into Cura and print it. And that's it, you're done. So thank you so much for being part of this, the audience for this video, and I hope you liked it. We have many more tutorials coming up. You can view them and become a SketchUp master yourself. So see you again.